Hello, my name is Rachel Riley, and today I will be illustrating and explaining how a mutation caused by an addition or deletion of one base pair results in the production of a non-functional mutant protein. So first, we're given a normal amino acid sequence and a mutant sequence, and we are trying to figure out what happened to the normal sequence to make it a non-functional protein, whether it be its insertion, deletion, or something else. So we are going to decode the amino acids into all of the codons that they represent. So we're going to do this for both the normal and the mutant strands. So for example, methionine codes for AUG. Tryptophan's codon is UGG. Phenylalanine can code for 2, so it's UUU or UUC. And then the codons for threonine are ACU, ACC, ACA, or ACG. So once we've decoded all of the amino acids to all of the corresponding codons, we can start to compare the normal strand to the mutant strand and see which base pairs match up and which ones do not. So A matches with A, U matches with U, and G matches with G. Same thing with tryptophan, U matches with U, G and G, and G and G. And then this U is supposed to match up with another U, but you can see that it does not match up with an A, so this is where we can tell the mutation has occurred. So this A is an insertion. And we can tell that because we can see it in the mutant strand, but we cannot see it in the normal strand. So what we can do now is start matching up the individual bases that we see to determine what the mutant protein sequence would be. So this U would match up with this U, and then this U would match up with this U as well. And we can tell that it is a U because it needs to match up with another U, so it wouldn't be a C or an A. Same thing with the C. The C would match up with another C, and it has to because this C is already determined in the sequence, so it would match up with this C instead of the U. And then the A would match up with the A, and then the C, since it's already determined in the sequence, it would match up with the C and it wouldn't match up with another U. So to find out the mutant protein sequence, all we have to do is to combine all of the base pairs that we determined by matching them all up into one sequence. So AUG, UGG, UUC, and then AC. And you can kind of check your work by looking at the normal strand, and it should be the same thing. And so this would be our mutant protein sequence, AUG, UGG, UUC, and AC, and then what is in yellow can be is our determined mutant protein sequence, and then this in the pink is what it could be to finish out the three base pair sequence. So it could either be U, C, A, or G, and we don't know because the mutant strand had ended, so we couldn't tell which one it would be. That concludes my presentation. Thank you so much.